Passion. Passion's a tricky subject. You see a lot of successful people talking about the importance of pursuing one's passion. You might be in a confused space of your own where you're unsure of how to pursue your passion. Or you could be so used to hearing this over and over again that now it's just too cliche for you to even consider it. I know I've been in these situations, and time and again my mind wanders off into areas that I don't want it to, where I question every single thing that I'm doing. When I quit my comfortable corporate job, I didn't do it because that was the cool thing to do. I did it because I knew that I'd learned all that I could at this job. And I had a clear idea of what I needed to do with the startup that I'd founded while I was working at this job. And in that transition from working for someone else to being my own boss, I faced numerous challenges and hurdles which are super stressful, but nevertheless worth it. If I hadn't gone through those, I would never have found out what I wanted to do in life, and I would probably still be stuck at the same dead-end job. The biggest misconception people have when they listen to narratives such as this is that these people who have taken the leap have life completely figured out. This person has the clarity of an 8K UHD TV and knows exactly what he or she wants to do with their life. But that couldn't be farther from the truth. Because although when I quit my job, I had a vision, that vision has evolved to a very different one today. And knowing that, I know for the fact that it's going to change even further, and I'm willing to keep an open mind to it. The path to finding your passion is one of the most challenging things you'll encounter in life, provided you do take up that challenge, of course. But the benefits of pursuing your passion is multifold. It can make your time truly worth it while you're alive. The moment you find something that you're inherently drawn to, with no need for an external factor to motivate you to wake up and tackle the day, life will never be the same again. There could be bigger social consequences with this too. And that's not something a lot of companies or schools or even countries for that matter are taking too seriously. Aditya Bharadwaj is a screenwriter who currently works with Saad Khan. We talk about his experience with AIB, All India Bagchor, and we also talk about this complicated subject, passion.
In India, we're all taught to your first hurdle in life is, at least for guys, I don't know about women, but for guys, you have to be financially stable enough to attract a bride. That's sort of the mentality that's drummed into people, which is why this whole angst of making it before you're 30, but 30, 31, I need to be settled or whatnot. That doesn't work. It may have worked before, but even if you're from a purely selfish standpoint, the Acche Din and all that, if you want the economy to be successful, you need every citizen to be providing a skill of value that only they can uniquely provide, because they can do it really well. And if everyone does that, everyone's life is actually easier.
Yeah.
If you let the entrepreneurs be entrepreneurs and the artists be artists and the guys who are truly interested in engineering be engineers, everyone does a better job.
It's a cumulative effort.
Yeah, you have better apps, you have better art and entertainment that you watch, you have better news, which is a whole different can of worms now.
Oh God.
That's the thing. I learned this from Jeff Bezos actually. He said, have a very fixed goal, but let your pathway to that goal be as flexible as possible. Have a distant goal that you know this is what you want to be or this is what you want to change, but the pathway to it, let it go however you want. Don't obsess over how you're getting there. Go however you want, you'll eventually make it. Or you might not, but...
No, at least you tried.
You tried.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the thing, right? I have a funny saying that my grandfather keeps throwing out there. He says, well, you won't win the lottery if you don't buy a ticket. So the fact of the matter is, unless you try, you will never freaking get
it. Yeah, true.
It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
That last part there, if you don't try, you'll never know, has honestly been a life-changing advice for me. It's something that we all take for granted these days. But what do we end up doing instead? We don't get started because we let fear get the better of us. We second guess ourselves and our choices and instead take the path that is most comfortable. Instead, just act, just do. Don't overthink things and get to acting on your ideas. And that's the only way you can get started on your path to finding your passion. Because like I stated earlier, the quest for passion is a super, super challenging one. But the rewards are completely worth it.
Thanks for watching.
Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. I release weekly content around self-development, personal growth, intentionalism, and so much more.
this is something that you would definitely want to stick around for. If you like to grow, improve, and one-up yourself, you would certainly dig my video podcast series. I sit down and have meaningful conversations with creators, entrepreneurs, freelancers, and so many more personalities. The feedback and traction has just been phenomenal, and I would highly recommend checking it out. I shall leave the links to the show in the description. And if you'd like to connect with me and see what it takes to be a creator, entrepreneur, and a podcaster without being formally trained in any of these fields, then you can connect with me on Instagram. Again, link is in the description. Thank you, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.